Hello guys, in this video I would like to discuss different programs as given here. First we will see LED blinking simplified program. In the last video we have seen LED blinking program. I would like to simplify or optimize this code. Writing optimized code is very important since it can save microcontroller resources like memory, execution time, etc. Let's start with simplifying this program. Here the main logic is written in 4 lines. So I would like to make it as simplify, that is I can make it in 2 lines. Let's see how we can do it. For on and off there are 2 lines, so we can write this logic in single line. That is, we can make it as LED equal to negation of LED. Here negation is a bitwise operator. That means if we give 1, it will give 0. If we give 0, it will give 1. So let's see how it works. Initially all the port values, as you see here, all the port values are high. If we don't write any program, you can see for port 1 or port 3, all the values by default red, that means high. Blue means 0. So for this port 2 0 also, the by default the value is high, that is 1. Initially the LED value is 1 by default. Now program start executing from main and it will enter into while of 1 infinity loop and LED equal to negation of LED. Now the LED is 1, so negation of 1, it will give 0. Initially 0 is assigned to LED. That means now the LED is off condition and there is a delay. Again it will go to infinity loop condition. Again it is true, it will come back to the main loop. Again now the LED is 0, so negation of 0, it will give 1. So 1 is written to LED. So now the LED is on. Okay, now again there is a delay, so this process will repeat like 0 1 0 1 0 1 and so on since it is a infinity loop. Let's see whether it is working or not. Let me stop this, check whether program is updated or not. So this is just now updated. Open, flash the program and play it. As you see, the program remains same, the application remains same, but only we optimize the code. So even I would like to optimize this code by moving this delay to a separate function. That means whenever we want delay, we just call that function. Just creating one function for delay. So I'm just taking variable for looping. So here you can see whenever I want delay, I just call this function. I'm just calling here. So previously there is a 20,000 delay. Okay, so if we call with this 20, so here already there is a 1,000. This is just a for loop for looping 20 times. That means 20 into 1,000, it will generate the previous delay, 20,000 delay. So this is the for loop for generating delay, so with semicolon, as discussed in the previous video. So this delay for loop, we are just repeating 20 times. That means 20,000 delay it will give. Suppose if we give 40 here, then the value of DEL will be 40. Then this loop will repeat 40 times since the DEL value is 40. So 40 into 1000, 40,000 times this loop will be, you will get 40,000 delay. That means the loop will be repeated 40 times only. So after for loop, if it is only one line, even if it is for, or if it is only one line, then no need of braces. I'm just removing the braces. This is enough, it will work. This is a simple delay function we made. So, and something is missing in this program. So we need a prototype. Function calling is there, definition is there. So we need a function prototype. So semicolon, so this is a prototype. So let me compile this. So as you can see, there is no errors. Let me execute, stop this, check whether XFile is updated or not. Now it's updated. Let me play this, flashing done. As you see, there is no program change, there is no application change, but we just optimize the code. So I just want to make it as 20. Again, we will see whether delay is reduced or not. Stop it, flash it again. Play it again. It's working. So now we will see how to blink two LEDs. I just want to take two pins, that is port 20, port 21 for LED 1 and 2. So same program, just want to change for another LED. Just copy paste this, only this line for LED 2. So just try to compile this. So let's see the circuit. So I have to modify this for another LED. So I'm just taking one more LED. This is green. Let me play this. And before that we have to flash the software. As you see, now two LEDs blinking. Now let's see how to program blinking 8 LEDs, that is port blinking. We have seen blinking 2 LEDs in the previous program, that is with individual bits or pins, that is with using S-bit. There is an option that accessing the whole port at a time instead of using individual bits. That means if we see port 2, there are 8 pins 0 to 7. These 8 pins or 8 bits we can access at a time using the P2. Let's start code this. So as defined, LEDs P2, that means wherever we use LEDs, that will be replaced with P2. This is just a macro, so all the macros will be expanded during pre-processing state. First, let me write a rough logic. First, 8 LEDs should turn on. Next, there should be some delay, so we can use this delay. Next, 8 LEDs should turn off and delay. So this is the program sequence. First 8 LEDs should turn on, delay. 8 LEDs should turn off, delay. So first we'll see how to turn on 8 LEDs at a time. So if you see port 2, we have 8 pins, that is 0 to 7. So if you want to turn on port 2 0th pin or port 2 0th bit, so we can write 1 to this bit. So if you want to turn on port 2 1 bit, so we need to write 1 to particular bit. And similarly, port 2 2, you need to write 1, and so on till 7th bit. So now all the 8 LEDs will turn on. So if you see a hexadecimal code for this 8Fs, it will give 0xFF. So you can use calculator also if you want. That is for 8 ones. So if you convert it into hexadecimal, it will be FF. So if we see the decimal equivalent, it will be 255. So
In embedded C programming, mostly we use hexadecimal notation. So you can use decimal also, but the preferred way is hexadecimal. So let's write this code in our program to turn on 8 LEDs. So, and there is a delay, similarly as discussed in the previous video. And now we need to write a code for 8 LEDs off. Similarly, so there is one more 8 bits. So I want to switch off first position, that is port to 0th pin. So we need to write to 0 to that particular bit, and port to 1 if you want to turn off, you need to write 0 and so on. So the equivalent hexadecimal value is 0x00. So we'll put this in our code. So here the 0x represents hexadecimal notation. So when we can use that, if you want to use decimal directly, you can use without any suffix. So if you are using hexadecimal, we must require 0x. So now the program is ready. Let's compile it. There are 0 errors, 0 1x. Build it. So let's make a circuit for this using Proteus. So total 8 LEDs we have to connect. So we can connect different color LEDs, red, green, ground here, so that will be there in terminal mode. Let's connect this to a common ground. So we'll see, we'll connect one by one. Port to 0th pin to this LED. So to make it very clear, now let's flash the software. Double click on it. So navigate to your X file. So this is just now created. Play it. As you see, it's blinking with some delay, all 8 LEDs at a time. So now next is, if I want to blink alternative LEDs. That is our next program. So alternative LEDs means side by side, first this LED will turn on, next this will be turn on, like 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0. That means these LEDs D1, D3, D5, D7 will turn on first. At that time, remaining will be off. The second time, D2, D4, D6, D8 will turn on. Remaining will be off. Let's code this. So the same thing you have to do. So need to write bit 1 for 1 0. This will be alternate means 0. This is 1, this will be 0. This is 1, this will be 0. This is 1, this will be 0. So the equivalent, you can see the equivalent hexadecimal value, that is 55. So you can see 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. So the equivalent, sorry, so if you see 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1, the equivalent hexadecimal will be 55, that is 0x55. So let's code this in our program. That is here, first 8 LEDs instead of 4 will be turned on, that is with positions 1 3, you can see 0 2 4 6. Next, so there is some delay, and LEDs, this will change to, so now remaining should be turned on. This time these positions like 1 3 5 and 7, so all this should be 1. So equivalent hexadecimal will be 0xAA. Let's copy and paste it in your program. So this will give alternative LEDs blinking. Just compile it, build it, go to the schematic, stop it, flash the program, updated program, play it. You can see it is alternatively it is blinking. Let's simplify this program also. Like instead of using 4 lines, so you can reduce it. So initially we need to initialize this before while. And then we can use LEDs equal to negation of LEDs. So this is a bitwise NOT gate, NOT operation. So that means initially all bits will be 01010101 is initialization. So whenever it executes this line, all these bits will be got negation, that is 10101010. That is EAM. So this loop will repeat continuously. So continuously this will change from 55 to AA, AA to 55 and so on. So let's execute this. Flash the software, play it. So same output you will get after simplified program also. And our next program is rotate LEDs. That means there are 8 LEDs connected in a circle as shown here. So 8 LEDs connected in a circle like this. One LED at a time, one LED has to rotate. That means first this LED should turn on, remaining is off condition. Next this one is on at the time, remaining all are off, and so on. So single LED will rotate continuously like this. That is in clockwise direction. So let's try to code this. So same, we can use this port. So first condition is first LED should turn on, first LED should turn on, remaining should off. So if you make this code in the boxes, that is this LED is on, remaining all are off. That is the code is 0x01. And next is this position is 1, remaining all are zeros. Next, this position is 1, remaining all are zeros, and so on. So until 7th bit is 1. So the code looks like this. First this LED is on, remaining off, this one is on, remaining off, this one is on, remaining off, and so on. So after this, again it has to execute these lines and so on. Continuously this has to be repeated. So then the LED is, our single LED will rotate. So let's try to make convert it to hexadecimal, 0x02. X04, this is 08, this is 10, 20, 40, and then 80. So that means we can make program like initially LED is equal to 0x01 and delay. So I need to copy paste. Let's compile this, build it. So execute this in a flash the software, play it. Yeah, so as you see, eight single LEDs rotating one by one. So if you want to reduce some delay, we can do it like 30. So the LED will move even faster. Build it, stop, flash the software, execute this. Yeah, so now I would like to optimize this code. So there are 8 delays plus 8 lines of code, so we can avoid this using a for loop and using some so as you see the codes, it looks like initially one is here, it is shifted by one, next it is shifted by one, and then one, and so on. It looks like it's a left shift operation. So if you apply a left shift operator, you can achieve this pattern. So let's try to do this in code. So initially there should be one initialization that will be moved out of while of one. This is the initial condition. Sorry, it should be inside while of one only. Let's write a for loop. I will just comment it out. for loop, equal to 0, loop less than, so how many times we need to left shift, so this is initial condition 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 times we have to do the shifting one by one. That is 7 here, 0 to 6 times, plus plus. Now the first LED is on already, so now we need to make one left shift. Left shift by 1. This is the left shift operator in C language. It's very important to learn left shift, right shift, and all the logical operators for embedded C. So next time, it will, after executing this line, it will go again for incrementing. Now the loop will be incremented by 1, and again it will check for the condition. Now 1 less than 7, that is true condition, it will come below LEDs equal to LEDs left shift 1. So first time by default is 1, next time it will be 0x02, and for next loop it will be 0x04, and so on. Until it will reach 7th bit position, that is the loop will be 6 now, 6 less than 7, so it is true condition, it will execute, and again left shift by 1 as shown here. Let's execute this. So, and we need a delay for each and every position. So since it is in while of 1, so this loop will be, this conditions again, this will be initialization will be 1, 0, 0, 1, and then 2, 4, 8, and so on. So it will, so there is error, so we need to declare this LP. Now 0001x. Let's stop this, check XFL is updated or not. This is just now created, updated. Just play it, same output, we just optimize the code. So previously 16 lines, now roughly 5 lines we made it. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.